a former UofL law school employee accused of promising scholarship money to students that the school didn't have is now facing a serious charge. WLKY's Erica Coghill was in the courtroom this morning. She's now live in our newsroom with the details. Erica?
Lexi, 34-year-old Brandon Hamilton was arraigned today. He's charged with unlawful access to a computer in the second degree. Authorities say the crime happened from February through May of last year.
So nobody's allowed to give up money that doesn't have authority.
This man did, and it landed him before a judge Tuesday, facing 5 years in prison and thousands of dollars in fines. UofL Law School's former assistant dean for admissions, Brandon Hamilton, is now facing a felony charge after authorities say he promised students scholarship money the school didn't have, more than $1 million beyond the budget.
And I was shocked, and of course, it's a huge challenge to find that out right when you start.
Susan Duncan was just 6 days into her new job as dean of UofL's law school when she tried to grant more than 100 students their scholarship money and realized the numbers didn't add up.
We were budgeted for about $550,000 for those first-year scholarships, and it came out to $1.3 million, around that amount, so it was approximately $800,000 more.
For a three-year scholarship, that means they were about $2.4 million over budget.
Once I discovered it, I mean, we just had to make sure that we would honor those scholarships.
The school's been able to raise the funds to cover the first 2 years for all the 104 students. The big question is why Hamilton allegedly did it. He and his loved ones declined to comment in court, and Duncan didn't have any answers either.
I have no idea, and I really can't comment on that.
What she does know, it won't happen again. The incident prompted an internal audit.
We have some new checks and balances and more documentation and more spot checking.
Hamilton was fired last July. He went on to work for the National College of Natural Medicine in Portland, Oregon. He's due back in court August 28th and has no bond. Today in court, the Commonwealth attorney said Hamilton's not considered a flight risk. Erica Coghill, WLKY News.